This week, the PCC Cup Series returns to the New York Autoring, the site of the fastest speeds on the calendar. Clara Kendall won the pole for race number one. As we take you through the 40 cars that are starting race number one, the track here, the pole set by Clara Kendall was at 247 miles per hour. So the superspeedway package that was introduced last season is still around. And I think the cars are actually going a little faster even than they were last year. Possibly because qualifying was held when it was very cloudy out, so the cars had a lot more speed to work with. So Clara Kendall is the holder now of the fastest lap set in PCC Cup Series history at this track, 247.546 miles per hour, I believe it was. As we take you through the field there, you can see Whitney Fuller starting pretty far back, Ryan Matthews, couple guys really not having quite strong of a run as they would really be hoping for. As we go back through the field, Casey Lester in race number one, surprised to see him in there after a strong run. Mark Donovan making his first start of 2014. Jacob Eichholz didn't have a very strong qualifying effort, so he's starting near the back. And Sylvia Rinaldi shanked her lap in qualifying. She had an engine trouble that put her in the back of the field. Gaspar D'Souza on pole for race number two, as Gabriel Messina has a very strong qualifying effort. His car isn't very strong. Aaron Williams are making her first start of 2014. Tom Delgado and Les Jackson. Jackson is back for a race. And we have a new team that's making their full-time debut, Triple XXX Racing. AJ Murphy's back there in the 23. Triple XXX Racing submitted their forms at the beginning of the season to run a 58 car with Sam Smith. We didn't see them for the first two rounds, but now they're here with a two-car team driving Chevy SSs in the 04 and the 40. Good to see them finally getting on the grid. We didn't really expect them to see them at all, to be honest, but here they are today, and they set quite a strong qualifying effort for both cars, actually. John Jefferson driving the 04 car, he ran last week in the 76 car for Cowboy Racing at Phoenix, their home track. Going back in the pack, Junior Hardern has his best qualifying effort of the season. He is starting in 34th place. As we continue to cycle back, we actually had three cars that did not qualify for this race. As we get to the last row here, Matt Brinson and John Kirkpatrick round out the field. Creeper Stevenson, Eunyoung Kim, and Chris Washer were deemed too slow to start the race as they were impeding cars even in qualifying. Pulsar for race number one, Clara Kendall leads the field to the green flag. Claire Aussier on her outside, getting a good push from Damon Jones there. On the bottom, Joe Craig starting in fourth place. And both sides of the field, outside and inside, seem to get a good jump on the start there. So you see there's a separation for the top seven, just a little bit starting to grow. Lenny Jacobs and Kyle McQuilla on the outside starting to make a push up towards there. Clara Kendall goes high, trying to block Claire Aussier, but Aussier dives low with a good push from Joe Craig, and Aussier is going to take the lead going into turn number three on the first lap here, and she is going to lead lap number one as they come onto the tri-oval. Mark Donovan in this 83 car. Kurt Pliskin ran the 81 last week, and since it's the fourth entry, the 83 and the 81 are both related, so he got this car into race number one last week. This is Mark Donovan's first race of the season, and he's running back in 37th place. Not a very good run for him, but it's good to see him back in the sport here. Here we've got Claire Aussier running in the lead with Ian Elias giving her a good push out front of the field. Laris Ryu, I think that's Laris Ryu, is in third place battling with Lenny Jacobs for that position. Ian Elias giving him a good push. Here's the two car. This is Sylvia Rinaldi. She had some engine trouble on her qualifying lap, so she qualified dead last. But she's working her way through the field. She's up to 24th now by lap number 5. And, it looks like she's making mincemeat of the back markers back there. Here's Lenny Jacobs, and we've got the 52, the 32, and the 12. Second, third, and fourth here on lap number 6. It looks like Ian Elias is going to try and disrupt that a little bit, put himself up in front. And the one car is trying to do that as well. But Paloma Autosport having a very good run here early on. Casey Lester is starting to lose the draft back here in lap number 7. Surprised to see him make the make race number 1, to be honest, but looks like he's struggling to keep up with the pack. Richard Hertz now is running in 5th place on lap number 8, having a very strong run. for the German. I didn't expect to see him up front on these road or on these super speedways. He's more of a road course expert himself, but he's having a good run so far. 32nd on back now. Lap 10 of 88 is starting to lose the pack a little bit. You can see Luke Pellerin leading this group as they start to lose the pack. They're really straggling. I'm not sure if they're trying to stay out of trouble or if they're just having trouble hanging on to the pack. Joe Craig now is having a turnaround season. He didn't qualify for too many races last year. He DNQ'd for quite a few, but on the super speedways, this car is dynamite. So he is up in second place, trying to make a move on Claire Aussier to take the lead. Lenny Jacobs, lap number 11, has trouble. He's slowing up the pack, and it looks like he's going to drop out of the race there on lap number 11. Huge blow for that team. He was really hoping for a good run here today, and he was running up front. He nearly won Talladega last year, except he got involved in a wreck during the green-white checkered. Claire Aussier leads the field still up front, and it looks like here comes Silvia Rinaldi. That car was fastest in both practice sessions, but unfortunately her qualifying didn't show for it. She just blows right on by Clara Kindle, and looks like she's up to second now. So Manticore 1-2-3. Joe Craig trying to change that there. He moves up to third place, but Silvia Rinaldi on the backstretch. You can see the second pack back there, how far back they are. I don't think they'll be able to catch this main group. But Silvia Rinaldi head into turn number 3, she sweeps down and she takes the lead with clearly the strongest car on the track. Here is Daniel Sharp running with, I think that's Greg Woodard, and Jacob Eichholz back there in the pack. They're losing touch with the leaders. Silvia Rinaldi now has opened up a huge gap over the rest of the field, and if she pulls out that far, I think she's going to get swallowed up, but that car is so powerful that she can just hang out there away from them while they fight back there for position. And that doesn't seem quite right. I think the officials might have to look at that car after the race. Here's Kyle McWallah, who's leading the second pack on lap number 18. This is 8th place through 33rd, so he's leading the pack with Lars Ryu and a few other drivers. Here's Brian Gallagher, who's working his way up towards the front of the second pack. He won at Phoenix last week by leading, I believe he led every single lap in that race, if I'm not mistaken. But here he is running up in the top 10 now, lap number 21, nearly at the 1/4 mark in this race. Kenny Steffens now hanging up with the lead pack, doing a good job. He's running in 5th place, getting a good push from Richard Hertz there in the number 466 car, but Kenny Steffens having a very strong run. Good to see him back after that injury that he suffered at Dwyer 3 years ago that knocked him out for a very long time. Damon Jones leading the second pack now, having a very strong run. He lost the first pack, but he's definitely working his way up towards the front, and Damon Jones having a strong run here today. He considers himself to be best on the super speedways, and he is no doubt showing it here today, leading the second pack here. Now, Kenny Steffens can't quite hang on with the first pack. They're just running two single file up there, a couple cars on the outside, but the speed that they're running means that he is going to start losing the main pack, just like these drivers have lost the second pack themselves. Ike Durbin and Daniel Sharp and a couple others hanging back there. Duncan Cobb gets hooked by, that's a rough situation. He got hooked by Alex Phillips and collided with Ben Atkins, and I think there's quite a bit of side damage on both of those cars. As you can see now, they've really dropped off from that pack there, and that damage looks to be a lot greater than it would seem. As you can see there, they collided, and the left side on Duncan Cobb's car is all bent out of shape. So he is definitely losing some speed there. Casey Lester is the first car to go a lap down. Casey Lester, this is lap number 31 of 88, so hopefully he can latch on with a pack and prevent himself from losing any more laps, but tough break for the 13 team. They made it this far, and they made it into race number one here, but I guess they just don't have the aerodynamics that they need to keep up with the main pack. You can see here Duncan Cobb, yeah, he is very slow. He is losing quite a bit of time. Him and Ben Atkins have lost touch with the second pack that formed there. and they're going to need to pit here pretty soon if they're going to keep themselves from going a lap down. Preston Bell has moved up into, I believe this is in the top 10. Preston Bell doing an excellent job here today. Yeah, this is the new second pack. This is 8th through 15th, and Preston Bell is in that. Ben Atkins pits on lap number, I think this is lap number 35, and he brings his car into the pits to get that damage repaired. Stringfellow Vincent has a trouble, has an engine trouble with that car, as he's running back in about 31st, and tough break for him. He was hoping to have a good points day today, avoid some trouble by hanging in the back, but unfortunately his day is going, I believe his day is going to end here today. James Hewitt and Kelly Blackwire make some contact there, trying to get around Duncan Cobb. Duncan Cobb still hasn't brought his car into the pits yet, but he's really slow. You can see here, even these drivers who have lost the main pack are really starting to lose it. There you see, Ryan Matthews into the outside wall. Dan Frey got hooked a little bit by Greg Maddox there. You can see Ryan Matthews drifted up the track. I guess he wanted to get out of that hornet's nest that was going on there. And, well, that's one way to do it. Guess you could put yourself into the wall. Duncan Cobb finally brings his car into the pits on lap number 39. Red flag being displayed there. Looks like the pits might be closed for something. Let's take a look here. Lap number 40, caution number 1. Richard Hertz gets hooked by Clara Kindall and all go into the wall. Claire Aussier is involved. It looks like Ian Elias is involved, and those were the leaders. That was the lead pack right there. As you can see, the second pack filing through. Looks like she was just trying too hard to catch up to Silvio Rinaldi. Gave Richard Hertz a bump, and that bump sent him onto the apron and out of control. Here we go on board with Joe Craig. The one driver in this pack behind it who managed to avoid the incident, you can see some expert driving there, dives onto the apron, goes high, and he misses the wreck. And excellent driving by Joe Craig, as looks like the brakes are starting to go on Kelly Blackwire's car as she runs into the back of Ryan Matthews there entering the pits. Looks like Silvia Rinaldi is going to win the battle off of pit road, and she will lead the field on the green flag. Duncan Cobb, Ben Atkins, and a few other cars there on the bottom are one lap down. As Silvia Rinaldi leads the field, there's Laris Riu back there in second place. Alina Lazareva is up to third place in the 59 car. She had a very good pit stop and was able to bring her car up towards the front. So now it looks like Silvia Rinaldi is going to start gapping the field once again as Laris Riu is struggling to get by lapped cars. Here's Pete Maverick pushes up the track and Barbara Burt, and we've got caution number 2 as this is the big one. Oh, we've got a car in the fence. I think that's Ingrid Hadeland. Oh, we've got Kyle McWella rolling. Preston Bell rolling. Quite a few cars are involved. Luckily for luckily all drivers were able to get out of their cars fine. Couple cars had, or a couple drivers took some time getting out, but everyone was able to get out of their cars fine. No serious injuries in this accident, as these cars are going 240 plus miles per hour. This accident wasn't too bad, but as you can see, most of the field was involved. And that's going to take out a lot of the contenders here today. Silvia Rinaldi and Laris Riu bring their cars into the pits, but Joe Craig didn't pit, so he leads on the restart. On the outside, Damon Jones and Whitney Fuller in the top three there. So they're having very strong runs now that some of their contenders have been eliminated from contention in that huge accident back there with Pete Maverick and Barbara Burt, a couple other cars that were running up front, Kyle McWalla. Tough break for all of those who were involved, but now Joe Craig starts to gap the field. As you see back there, Silvia Rinaldi stuck in traffic behind, I think that was James Hewitt. Clara Kindall brings her car into the pits, and after that damage, she ran out for a bit, and they couldn't quite figure out what was wrong with the car, so they would retire that car, unfortunately for her. Here's Whitney Fuller up to second place now, getting a good shove from Damon Jones, and she has had quite a stellar PCC Cup Series career this season. She finished in the top 5 at Phoenix, but unfortunately finished last at Road Atlanta. She is having a good season so far after running with Clayson Enterprises last year. In 2 years ago in 2012, she did she didn't do quite a good job there. Damon Jones leading the second pack, right behind, well, leading this group right behind Joe Craig, unable to catch him. As you see there, Kenny Steffens is trying to battle for second place. Kenny Steffens coming back, and he is going to take second place away from Damon Jones in the DJ Motorsports car. Mark Donovan's good day. He had avoided all of the accidents and is running up near the top 20. Unfortunately, his day is going to end here on lap number 54. He was running in 15th place. And I guess Retro 80 Racing's engine package couldn't quite handle the high speeds here today. As Joe Craig in the 29 car, I believe he has yet to win a race here in the PCC Cup Series. He's won a few poles, but Joe Craig now driving for Petrol Tech Engineering. This used to be Raptor Racing, but they were bought out. So you see there, he's leading over Silvio Rinaldi up to second place with Whitney Fuller battling for that position. So it's only a matter of time, I think, before she takes the lead, and she does here the lap later. So Silvio Rinaldi back up front. This is the dominant car here today, arguably, seeing as the rest of the leaders, sans Joe Craig, were taken out in that first caution. Jacob Eichholz having a strong run. He's up to 6th place on lap number 59, and if you remember correctly, he was one of the cars that lost the pack very early on. So I guess his strategy is playing out quite well, doing a good job here today running up in the top 10. Silvio Rinaldi leading, and I really don't think that anybody's going to be able to catch her. The Italian driver who was brought on board Manticore Engineering this year showed some promise in some feeder series over in Europe, and they brought her on board. Here are Dan Foray and Greg Woodard, who have just kind of been putzing around in the back, dodging whatever wrecks have occurred. And this strategy is working for them. They're running in 12th and 13th, despite losing the main pack. So good finishes for Phoenix Performance Racing, even though their cars aren't quite up to snuff. We've got Alina Lazareva here, and Dan Lechleiter, and I believe that's Ryan Griffin running in 9th, 10th, and 11th. So strong runs for these drivers as well, staying out of trouble and really dodging whatever comes their way. They managed to avoid the main wrecks up there. Here's Ike Durbin running in 8th place, running the HP Engine Parts car for the first time this season. He's having a strong run up near the front. Joe Craig now trying to make a move on Silvio Rinaldi. Here comes the lap car of Kelly Blackwater. He makes a move on the bottom, but Blackwater's going to hold him up, and Silvio Rinaldi's going to hold on to the lead as Blackwater refuses to move over for Joe Craig, and she finally does, but that's really not the best backmarker work that I've ever seen. Silvio Rinaldi and Joe Craig go to lap, I believe that's James Hewitt. He just went 3 or 4 laps down. Now Alex Phillips is going another lap down. All these drivers have damage from a few wrecks that they're involved in earlier on. So Alex Phillips, he was having a strong run. I believe he was running in 14th place at that point. Here's Laris Ryu, and she's up to 3rd place now, leading the second pack as Joe Craig and Silvio Rinaldi have just pulled away from everyone else. The Indonesian Jet having a good run today as Kelly Blackwater getting ready to go another lap down and being a terrible backmarker once again. And Joe Craig is finally able to take control of the lead from Silvio Rinaldi here with just a few laps to go. This is with 4 laps to go. Coming here with just 3 laps to go, lap number 86, Alex Phillips is going to hold up Joe Craig on the outside as Silvio Rinaldi is going to take control. And oh no, he dives low and holds up Silvio Rinaldi on the bottom. And Joe Craig might be able to take advantage here, but he's having trouble picking a line. Alex Phillips trying inadvertently to determine this race, trying to pick a line. Finally, he goes high and Joe Craig goes low and around him. But with just 2 laps to go, lap number 87, Silvio Rinaldi looks like she's got... No, she's pitting. She gambled on her pit strategy, unfortunately, and it did not pay off as Silvio Rinaldi has to pit for fuel from the lead. And that means that Joe Craig, all alone up there in front, is going to take his first career PCC Cup Series victory here at New York Autoring here today. Well, here are the top 20 finishers, which... incidentally enough, happens to be these are the only cars that finished the race, so that makes this easy. Lars Riu finishes in second place after Silvio Rinaldi head to pit for fuel with just two laps to go. Kenny Steffens, Whitney Fuller, Damon Jones all get top fives. Excellent runs for all of those drivers and for Jacob Eichholz, who fell back early on but finished in sixth place. Alina Lazareva seventh. Ryan Griffin and Ike Durbin teammates finish at 8th and 9th. And Dan Lecklater rounds out the top 10. Dan Ferrey and Greg Woodard, despite losing the pack for the majority of the race, finished 11th and 12th. Silvio Rinaldi's pit strategy, if you could call it that, landed her in 13th place. Casey Lester, despite falling a lap down early on, finishes in 14th. Stringfellow Vincent, who I mistakenly thought dropped out after slowing down on track, actually just had a fuel line issue and finished in 15th, two laps down. Kelly Blackwater finished 16th, two laps down. Alex Phillips, Ben Atkins, and Duncan Cobb, who both collided. And James Hewitt finished four laps down, but finished, and finished in 20th place. Decent run for him, despite the problems that his car suffered getting caught up in that accident on lap number 46. Now on to race number two. Here's Gaspar de Souza leading the field to the green flag. He's got Barry Juveneau on his outside. Barry Juveneau and Denny Adams there. I believe both of them are in the bottom five in the point standings, so much so that drivers such as Eunyoung Kim, John Kirkpatrick, and Matt Brinson are in front of them in points. So that's going to be pretty embarrassing for them. They're going to have to step it up here today if they're going to have any chance of getting out of that interesting situation. Here's John Jefferson running in 7th place with the Triple XXX Motorsports team, and if you do the math, that's I believe that's 9 X's, so that's interesting, but they're doing a fantastic job here so far today. John Jefferson is running up in the top 10, I believe he qualified up there too, and Sam Smith, his teammate, who was the original driver of this car listed in a number 58, that was supposed to show up, is running in 17th, so both cars running in the top 20 would actually advance on to race 1 if the race were to end right now. Here's Tom Delgado running a special scheme. I believe he's got Citibank on that car. He's moved up to 2nd place in front of his home crowd. To do really well at this track would mean a lot to Delgado, as he himself is a New York native. So he is doing a good job here today, putting on a show for the crowd, and he's running up in the second place, trying to get a good run up to Gaspar de Souza. Here's Les Jackson in the number 11 car. Honestly, didn't expect to see him back, but Johnson Racing put together a deal to get him into the field, and, well, PCC Cup Series likes to keep the fields even, and because they entered him, Creeper Stevenson got shoved out. There were 43 cars going for 40 spots here today, and his addition bumped out Creeper Stevenson, which I suppose is a good thing. Here's Erin Williams running a third car for the Williams Racing Team. She's up to 4th place, doing a fantastic job in this number 94 car. Not quite sure what that sponsor is, but she's working around Barry Juveneau there on the bottom. Gabriel Messina as well. Here's John Jefferson a couple laps later, working up to 3rd place. This is lap number 7. So this car definitely has a lot of speed. We honestly didn't expect to see this team at all, seeing as they filled out their paperwork for Road Atlanta and Phoenix and were on the entry list, but they never showed up. But they're here today, and they're running quite well, so it's a shame of what could have been with this team had they shown up a lot earlier on. Here's Gaspar de Souza running up front. This is lap number 9, and as you can see, there's a car up there that's already getting ready to go a lap down, and I think that's John Kirkpatrick. He's not being a very good backmarker today. He's blocking Barry Juveneau and the high lane, and they're splitting him down the middle, it looks like. Trying to, I think. Pick a line, seriously. Go on the high side. There we go. There we go. He picked a line, and looks like he's sticking to it. He's kind of being forced to stick to it, but AJ Murphy and a couple other guys are really stuck behind him. Denny Adams now up to 2nd place. This is the driver that's 2nd last in points, if you can believe it. More due to mechanical breakdown and bad luck than anything else. But he's proving to people that he can actually perform and he's doing a good job doing so. First caution of the day comes out here. Sam Smith hooks Robert Nelson into the inside wall. Both of them hard into the inside wall, and Ribot and Sam Smith, their days would end very early on here on lap number 13. And let's go on board with Smith here and see what he saw. He just turned him head on into the inside wall. And not sure on the medical conditions of both drivers, but they were both transported to a local hospital for observation. No word on what resulted from that. Gaspar D'Souza brings the field into the pits with Denny Adams right behind him. And Gabriel Messina stayed out on the restart, and he's going to lead the field on the green flag, as he didn't pit along with the two Lucas Motorsports cars back there of Ryan Jeffries and Ben Worthington. So Gabriel Messina now up front. He qualified quite well in the top five, and he's going to run up front and show what he can do. This is the first really good run that he's had. He started pretty well at Road Atlanta and broke down, and he was just deathly slow at Phoenix. But here he's running up front and showing what he can do to the PCC Cup Series crowd. Here's Billy Ray James, who stayed out under that last caution, and he's running in 17th right now. So you can see just kind of how slow he is. He's forming a train behind him, and he's losing the pack in front of him, so that should say enough right there. He's got Cody Deke and AJ Murphy and Chris Winter behind him. Matt Brinson had some problems. He comes out and runs into the side of John Jefferson coming out of the pits. You might want to use your mirrors there, or at least, does he have a spotter? I don't think he does. Oh dear, that's not good. Use the mirrors, son. So, You might want to get out of the way there. Matt Brinson being a moving roadblock, being turn number five here today. As you can see exactly what happened there. He came up, scraped the side of John Jefferson. I'm shocked that that wasn't a bigger incident. We missed this earlier, but under caution, Barry Juvenot. This was a few laps ago. Barry Juvenot suffered a rear suspension failure and dropped out of the race from second place. I'm sorry that we missed that, but at least we got to you there. Cale Bernfardt Jr., the Super Speedway Ace, as he likes to call himself, is up to second place, and actually having a pretty strong run for once. Although John Jefferson's going to come on the bottom here, and he's going to pass him, going low. So here is Junior Hardern, and he's actually competitive for once. He's running in 21st place. Still not quite good enough to get him into the first race, but he's decently competitive for once, actually running with a group of cars instead of in the back. Aaron Williams takes the lead away from Gabriel Messina with some help from Gaspar D'Souza and Nicholas Corradovo's back there, and she is aggressively defending that lead. I think she's going to hold on to it here for at least a little bit, blocking Gaspar D'Souza there, but Gaspar D'Souza later that lap gets some help from Denny Adams, and he's going to take the lead back just like that. So Gaspar D'Souza back up front in his dominant car. Looks like Gabriel Messina is going to try and battle for second there with Denny Adams, and Gaspar D'Souza is going to continue to hold on to the lead. AJ Murphy now. AJ Murphy is back driving for Zach Tech. He's running in 18th place, and he's going to be back in this car in Carbondale since he is a short track expert himself. You see back there Tom Delgado. He's got to be slightly irked to be running behind a former teammate of his that he let go. John Kirkpatrick once again going a lap down, being a terrible backmarker. And he's going to hold up the bottom again, and now he's going to hold up the high lane, and is he going to hold up the bottom again? I don't think so, but he's forming a bottleneck right behind him there. Oh, we've got three wide, almost four wide with Lewis Jones there. Scott Wullen now trying to go low. Oh, we've got four wide with him, Junior Hardern, Chris Winter, and Cody Deacon. He hooks him. Cody Deke hooks him, hits the inside wall, spins across the grass, and they both collide. No caution, but those cars are severely damaged. We're going to go on board with Cody Deke and see what happened here. As Scott Wullen, he just runs alongside of him, hooks his fender, and gets damage on his hood and his sides. And that car's a mess. I think he's going to stay in the race, but that's a lot of damage. They pit the next lap and get that taken care of. Both of them coming into the pits, and they're going to go multiple laps down after that. Here is Gaspar D'Souza leading once again. John Jefferson behind him, battling with Tom Wilson for second place. First time we've seen him all day up front. And he's doing a good job so far here today. Tom Wilson up to second place. Didn't quite expect to see him running as well as he is today. Dale Kensington Jr., being a decent back marker, I suppose. He pinched the bomb a little bit there, but he's not nearly as bad as John Kirkpatrick, and he's running pretty well. Lap number 34, he's lasted longer on the lead lap than Casey Lester did. But then again, Casey Lester had no cautions early on. Oh, Gabriel Messina's got a problem from up front. He's reporting an engine problem in that number 99 car. He's reporting he's down to seven cylinders, so they're going to pull that car in and take a look at it, see if they can fix it up a little bit. Matt Brinson and Chris DeSanta and Alex Alenko are now about to go a lap down. Matt Brinson, this is not his first time going a lap down. I believe he's going three or four laps down right now. But Chris DeSanta being a good backmarker, staying out of everyone's way, but Alex Alenko, pick a line. Oh, he's blocking all over the place, and now Sam Lussar is up to second place due to that. So good run for Sam Lussar. These drivers are really, the main pack has really grown since I've last talked about that. Or at least it seems like that from last race, but Ryan Jeffries now up to second place in this number 26 car, having a strong run. Proving the talent that he had at Johnson Racing was actually being untapped. Either that or they're just giving him bad cars. Alex Pawsington up to third place, having the best run of his career. Ben Worthington reporting a fuel line problem from the top five, so he dives into the pits, and he's going to get that repaired here. He will go one lap down, getting that damage repaired to the fuel line. Gabriel Messina back out on track, and he is really slow. He is that is some questionable moving that he's doing there. He's all over the track. Gabriel Messina probably should have just retired it when he had the chance. And it looks like Billy Ray James has picked a low line, and the back markership here is just absolutely atrocious. At least John Kirkpatrick was kind of forced to pick the high side because he was getting passed by Billy Ray James there. But James is holding up, looks like Jeffries and Adams and Bracci there. Bracci now up to third place. But Ryan Jeffries now takes the lead in front of the New York Autoring crowd here, and he is going to lead this lap here in front of Denny Adams. Adams tries to make a move, but he throws the block. So he is leading here today. Oh, we've got him go. Oh, caution number two. I believe this is caution number two. Lap number 44, and Magenta Nelson Andrew, and looked like we had one more car involved in that. Magenta Nelson Andrew and Candace Bowman, and Alex Alenko just piles in and rolls the car on the apron, and well, that's one more back marker down. So looks like Lewis Jones got pinched down trying to avoid John Kirkpatrick. Cameron Taylor brings his car into the pits. Unfortunately, they can't figure out what's wrong with it, and he's done for the day. Denny Adams leads on the restart. There you've got Scott Wullen and Ben Worthington on the tail end of the lead lap. Looks like Worthington is going to dive low and pass Wullen. Gabriel Messina holding up the inside like there's no tomorrow there. So Jeffries takes the lead on the inside with Worthington, who's on the tail end of the lead lap. And looks like those two are actually working together. Messina, as I mentioned before, looks like he's even slower than John Kirkpatrick, which is a feat in itself. But Messina, you should probably have just retired it when you got the chance. Ryan Jeffries is leading this race, but Ben Worthington on the tail end of the lead lap. Looks like Denny Adams is going to try and go low, maybe pass him. Nope. He protects Worthington, trying to keep Worthington on the lead lap, drafting with him. Worthington actually has a very strong car here today. He's just stuck a lap down, but Denny Adams fighting for that position, and Denny Adams is going to take the lead back once again. Worthington trying to do all he can to stay on the lead lap, but unfortunately it's not meant to be, as him and Les Jackson are going to make a move there. Les Jackson goes high to stick with Worthington, but Worthington is going to get passed, and Jackson is going to get passed by Jeffries there. So Alex Pawsington sticking with this lead group of four cars and Worthington, and he's running up in third place. This is arguably the best run of Posington's short career. He's doing quite a good job here today, and I wouldn't be surprised if he was in contention for the win at the end of this one. Posington having a very strong run up in the top five. And here is AJ Murphy running in 10th place on lap number 54, doing an excellent job in this number 23 car. It's a shame he doesn't have a full-time ride, and I think that's Junior Hardern right behind him in 11th. So Junior Hardern doing an excellent job here today, actually being competitive for once. So maybe this is a change in... maybe they changed his car for the better here today. So hopefully we'll see more of him up front. Chris Winter goes low to avoid Scott Wallen, collects Jordan Demas and Ramsey Cockener, goes into the outside wall. Caution number 3 on lap number 54. Both cars would continue on without too much problems, but that looked kind of silly. Looked like, he just went low. Jordan Demas had his nose in there, and that collected all three. Ramsey Cockener has some left side damage on that car. But all three of those cars would continue on without too much of a problem. Denny Adams leads on the restart. We've got Ryan Jeffries behind him. Ben Worthington starts. For some reason this race, they decided not to run double file restarts. I'm not quite sure why they did that. But looks like Ryan Jeffries is going to take a look on the bottom, and he's going to take the lead away from Denny Adams with some help from Alex Posington and Aaron Williams back there. Running in fourth place, looks like we've got three wide between Adams, Worthington, and Williams as Posington leads that lap. Alex Posington moves his way into the lead, and what did I say before about him being in contention for this win? Here we're on, I think this is lap number 59 of 88, and he's still up front contending, so he's doing an excellent job here today. Like I said, don't be surprised if this guy wins one of these super speedway races here sometime soon. As Aaron Williams now sweeps on the bottom and is going to take the lead with some help from Tom Wilson. And here's AJ Murphy, and he's got a problem. He dives to the apron. The unreliability of these Zaktec cars is apparent. This was actually one of Bobby Dollar's cars that he ran in the top five last year, and I'm surprised that it lasted this long. Tough break for AJ Murphy. He's going to drop out of the race from 18th place, although that car was much better than where he was running at that point. Tom Wilson running on the outside, Les Jackson's leading, and Tom Wilson having the race of his career so far. He's running up in the top 10 and really doing an excellent job, proving that he his job as the test driver last season actually did give him quite a bit of experience in these cars. Tom Delgado was in the second pack after AJ Murphy had his problems, but now he's really started to separate himself, partially due to John Bracci losing the first pack. And he's really starting to catch up to that group. His car has come to life here today. He was running in 30th for most of this race, but oh, where have we seen this before? Ben Worthington on the tail end of the lead lap with Ryan Jeffries right behind him. So Worthington trying once again to stay on the lead lap, but looks like Les Jackson's going to pass him for the lead there. And I don't know how much longer he's going to stay in that position, considering he doesn't have a teammate behind him anymore. Tom Delgado now has caught up to the main pack, and this is going to get very interesting because that car is flying like a rocket up towards the front, and he is just doing a fantastic job here today, and it's going to be interesting to see how he contributes to the result of this race. As now Gaspar de Souza has taken the lead once again on lap number 66. Tom Delgado fighting his way up to second place behind Ryan Jeffries there on the bottom. He's going to take away second position from him and work his way up towards the front. Gabriel Messina hanging on the high side. Ryan Jeffries has enough of it and puts him into the wall. Caution number 3 here, and it looks like we're going to have a multiple car accident as the second pack comes screaming through, and they're all going to get involved in this wreck. Going on board with Ryan Jeffries to see what he saw, he tries to go low, but Gabriel Messina just kind of drifts around, puts him into the wall, and there you can see all the cars that are filtering in through that wreck on the bottom, running the transition between the banking and the apron, and that just sets their cars loose. Cale Bernhardt Jr. gets involved, Junior Hardern. John Jefferson was having an excellent run. There you see Andy Lambert flipping over. He had a great run going, too. All those cars had great runs. Here we go on board with JC Carpenter, and you can see exactly what he saw. He was hanging way in the back, sees the smoke, goes high, and coming to the caution, there he goes by Denny Adams, and a few of these cars here on the apron, and he is going to end up in sixth place after that. So fifth place, no, yes, fifth place on the restart. So excellent job for JC Carpenter. This race has had comers and goers, and Tom Delgado and JC Carpenter are definitely coming towards the front. Looks like Aaron Williams has a little bit of damage there on that 94 car, but Gaspar de Souza leads. Looks like Tom Delgado and Alex Pawsington are working together on the high side there to get around Williams, whose damage appears to be affecting her a little bit, as Gaspar de Souza really starts to pull away. But now Tom Delgado, whose car appears to be the only car that can equal Gaspar de Souza's, makes a move for the bottom, and he's going to take the lead here in front of the home crowd with just a few laps to go. This is lap number 73 of 88, so 15 laps to go. Looks like Tom Delgado is going to sweep into the lead around Gaspar de Souza and lead that lap in front of the home crowd. Lewis Jones, who missed the wreck somehow, is running in fourth place on lap number 74. This team boycotted last year's race due to the Super Speedway package. I'm not sure why they decided to show up again. But here is JC Carpenter running in sixth place behind Aaron Williams in front of Chris Winter and Jordan Demas. Both of those were guys who were involved in one of the cautions before. But here we've got JC Carpenter having an excellent run in this underfunded number 79 car. Four cautions here today. Only the fourth was really that bad. Gaspar de Souza looking behind Tom Delgado, trying to get a good run here on lap number 77, coming to lap number 78. Only 10 more laps to go. We're going to see if either of these drivers, who are both looking for their first wins, can definitely go for it. They're the only two left that are up near the front. Alex Pawsington has dropped back and will be caught by the second pack. Lap number 80. Gaspar de Souza takes the lead. Just a few more laps to go as they're swapping positions up near the front. Lewis Jones has caught Alex Pawsington now. Looking low. Let's see if he can do it. Oh, he's got a problem. He's reporting the left rear suspension has gone sour on that car and has busted, so he is unfortunately going to drop out of the race from fourth position on lap number 83, just five laps from the finish. Tough break for him. I believe he's still going to finish in the top 20, if I'm not mistaken, though, because there's not too many cars left running. Tom Delgado takes the lead back once again on lap number 83, diving on the bottom, and he's going to take that back from Gaspar de Souza. So it's going to be a two-car battle for the lead at the finish. Here's Denny Adams, who was involved in caution number 4 on lap number 67. I call it caution number 3 when I call it. But Denny Adams, despite the damage, is in 7th place on lap number 85, doing a good job. Matt Brinson reporting a brake failure on that car, slides up the track, hits the outside wall, and he's going to slide down the track. I don't see a caution being thrown. Matt Brinson was running multiple laps down. He was running in 19th place on lap number 85. Speaking of lap number 85, here is Gaspar de Souza on the bottom, going to take the lead. Ben Worthington dives out of the way of the leaders. John Kirkpatrick going another lap down. I think that car might have something wrong with it. Either something wrong with it, or it's just that slow to begin with. Probably the latter. But Gaspar de Souza takes the lead away from Tom Delgado with just three laps to go, so Delgado's going to have to fight his way back up towards the front. Here's Billy Ray James, who... this car is normally really slow, but he's running in this group, and he's in 11th place. So he's doing battle with Dale Kensington Jr. back there, who's running in 12th. So that's going to be an interesting fight, and both are pretty much going to transfer into the main race, race number one at Carbondale, no matter what happens here today. Tom Delgado, white flag, in second place. He's going to make a move on the bottom there, coming into turn number one, and Tom Delgado is going to take the lead, entering turn number two. He's going to clear Gaspar de Souza. Can he hold on in front of his home crowd and win this one? Tom Delgado leading down the backstretch. Gaspar de Souza looks low, trying to make a move, but he thinks better of it. I think that Tom Delgado's got the distance that he needs. I don't see anybody in front that might hold them up out of turn number four. Tom Delgado is going to win his first PCC Cup Series race in front of his home crowd in New York Autoring. Despite losing the front two late in the going, Alex Posington finishes in third place, his best career finish. Aaron Williams and Chris Winter, who was involved in caution number three with Ramsey Cochner and Jordan Demas, round out the top five. JC Carpenter gets the 79 car of Circle Track Racing its best career finish. Denny Adams came into this race second to last in points. That's not going to be the case anymore with the 7th place finish and 37 points. And Nick Azur, we didn't talk about him all day, but he was the last car on the lead lap. He was involved in caution number 3 leading the second pack that piled in. This is where it gets interesting. Dale Kensington Jr. got around Billy Ray James for 11th place with 2 to go. We missed that enthralling battle back there. Chris DeSanta, driving for Racing with Racing for Craft and the Epsilon program, finishes in 13th place in the 157 car. Scott Wallen finishes behind all of these cars in 14th place, and Cody Deek finishes in 15th. John Kirkpatrick finished 4 laps down, but came home in 16th place. I believe that's his best career finish. He did it for Dale in the Dale Died for Our Sins number 3 car. Ben Worthington had a multitude of problems and finished behind John Kirkpatrick. Fuel system leak and brake failures on that car. Lewis Jones had a suspension failure and finished in 18th place despite falling out with about 5 or 6 laps to go. Matt Brinson, who fell out with 4 laps to go, was already 5 laps down, so he finished 9 laps adrift in 19th place, but that's good enough to move him up to the main race, race number 1 at Carbondale, along with John Kirkpatrick. And Cale Bernhardt Jr. rounds out your top 20 involved in caution number 4. He made it the furthest of the drivers who retired that were involved. Now let's take a look at points as Ben Atkins takes the lead over Clara Kindall in the point standings by 2 points, 109 to 107 points. Ike Durbin and Dan Lecler jump up to 3rd and 4th in the championship, followed by Stringfellow Vincent in 5th, basically holding station. Lars Ryu, Kenny Steffens, Ryan Griffin, Richard Dean MacGyver drops down to 9th, and Duncan Cobb down to 10th. Alina Lazareva holds on to 11th. Chris Winter rockets up into 12th place in the standings. Ingrid Hadeland drops a little bit. Lewis Jones and Joe Craig jumps up to 15th in the standings. James Hewitt has a very consistent showing and has remained in the top 20, I believe, all 3 weeks. Casey Lester runs very consistently in that 13 car and gets him up to 17th in points. Ian Elias drops from 3rd to 18th in the points. Brian Gallagher drops after winning last week, and Tom Delgado shoots up from 55th in the championship after Phoenix all the way up to 20th place with his win here today.